You guys ready? You ready? I'm not. Oh man, I hit all the wrong buttons here. Hold on. Here we go. Here we go. Hope you guys are ready. Because I'm not. What's up, fuckers? My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. Can't believe the second word of this stream was an insult. I guess that's how it goes. Thanks for coming, people. Thanks for coming. Keith Drones was first, maybe. Eric Allen is here. June Loco is here. Ken Hill. Adam Rusin. Keith Drones. Tommy Lou. BH Hitting. Ken Hill. Eric Allen. And Josh PFPV. What's up, folks? I just finished up giving up on Sean's rig here. Sean was having some pretty serious problems with this Acrobrat Duo, and I said, you know what? Just send it to me. I'll get it banged out and fixed up. And I can't. I did everything that I know how to do. Like, I did all the troubleshooting that that I know how, and I made it a little bit better. I made it a lot better. I made it better. Let's just say that. But it's still unflyable. Krunked had said he can fix this after we talked about this problem, and I described all the symptoms and shit. He said he could fix it in 5 minutes, so I'm gonna mail it to him so that he can fix it in 5 minutes, because I'm like 6 hours in. So yeah, I'm obviously a shitty fucking repair person, but whatever. I fucking try, you know? I try. But eventually, you know, sometimes give up. Remember, sometimes give up.
俺だってこのマイナス10度のところ縮みが取れるって頑張ってんだよ絶対やってんの必ず目標達成できるだからこそ言えばビバ
Sometimes I feel like I play Clam Man a little too much, but I don't care. It's my stream. You guys can fuck off. Not true at all. I love every single goddamn one of you. If you think I play Clam Man too often, then you're wrong. Eric Allen hopes I'm doing good today. I'm doing all right, Eric. I woke up at 5 p.m., so that was not a great start. I tried laying down earlier last night. I am fucking desperate at this point to fix my sleep schedule. I will do anything. So, yeah. It's no good. It's real bad. Like, I lay down like half an hour earlier each night, and then I just fucking lay there in a pit of either depression or anxiety or both, or just general half-assedness. Strange thing to say. Yeah, I don't know. It's just hopeless. I'm to the point where I'm going to sleep at 7 a.m. I don't know. I think at this point I need to push it, since pulling back is not working, I guess I need to push it forward, and tomorrow I'll go to sleep at 8, the next day I'll go to sleep at 9, and yeah, I guess I'll push it all the way forward to back to midnight. But yeah, I don't know. I've tried everything. So, yeah. Fuck me to death. Rawpix FPV says, "Hey dude, what a nice surprise. Wondered when your Rotorius frame is going to come out. I believe it's called the Ripper." Rawpix showing that he's an OG. I don't know. I feel like my relationship with Rotorius is kind of over, unfortunately. Yeah, that frame, I can pretty much guarantee you, will never see the light of day, unfortunately. There just seems to be no Rotorius doesn't seem to want to make it. I've tried and tried and tried and tried to get that thing made. I've spent tons and tons and tons of time. And yeah, it's just, I don't know what else to do. So I've kind of given up, unfortunately, and I'm just sort of moving on. Right now, in terms of a 3-inch micro frame, it's the BQE Rip Squeak Micro, is my current suggestion. It just doesn't, I don't know. I've kind of given up on frame design. I've tried and tried and tried and tried and tried over like the last 3 years. Everybody that I work with, it hasn't worked out. And it hasn't worked out enough times in a row that I'm just, at this point, I'm just kind of like, well, fuck it. I give up. I just can't keep pissing time away on frame projects that never happen. So yeah, it is what it is. I'm fine with it. Big ol' Lair, I've tried that too. It's just not fucking yeah, I don't know. Been trying that for the last 10 years, if I'm honest. All right, so it's 5-inch Friday. I'm gonna get you guys all warmed up for DJ stream, Backgrinder stream, and then when 9 o'clock hits, I'm gonna peace out so that we can all hop over and watch bot. So yeah, I don't know. Ken Hill, I've been thinking that. Ken Hill says maybe another 24-hour stream to reset the body. I've been really, really, really thinking that. I kind of want to. I've been thinking like, yeah, I don't know. I would love to do it. CMYK says that's what she said. I would love to start a 24-hour stream at like 3 o'clock on Sunday. With our regular stream and just run that motherfucker to 3 o'clock Monday. We'll see. Maybe I'll do it this weekend, maybe next weekend. But yeah, that's as good idea as any, right? Rawpick says, can't you team up with Bob Rugi for the frame? I've also tried that route and didn't really get anywhere. I think so many people would be happy about a proper 3-inch frame. Yeah, I agree, Rawpick. And that's why I spent so much time and effort and blood and sweat trying to make it happen. But yeah, it just didn't. And yeah, I've had the conversation with Bob, and he doesn't really sound interested in. So he's already made a frame very similar to what we're looking for, what I'm looking for, and what I think a lot of you guys are also looking for. It was basically like a mini floss, a little 3-inch floss, and he didn't like it at all. He didn't like the way that it flew. He didn't like anything about it, really. This is going back like a year, year and a half ago. Yeah, so there's a couple prototypes of it flying around, floating around. Well, no, flying around. But yeah, he has, I don't know, for whatever reason, he didn't like the way that that flew, and he just kind of has no interest in going that direction. So I tried, guys. I really did. I've tried everything that I can possibly think of, but I don't know. It's just not happening. So I'm moving on. That's cool that you remember that though. OG motherfuckers for life. Polly Lee FPV says, "Keep it up, my friend." Cheers. Thank you, Polly Lee. And then Frank Nicholas just said, "Thanks for the live stream notice, dear patrons." Thank you for bugging me, Frank, to do that. Because it's just it doesn't take me long to do. I'm now like in the flow. So when I stream, I post it on Discord now, Patreon, Facebook, and then yeah, you guys will know about it. 'Cause YouTube apparently does a really shitty job at letting you guys know. Even if you click the bell, which you still should, I think. Even if you click the, I don't know, whatever the fuck you want, it just doesn't, I don't know, YouTube just doesn't notify people. Yeah. News. I was hoping on waking up earlier than 5 p.m. today, so that I could head out to Best Buy. So My Hero 7, I think this is Hero 7 number 6, maybe number 7, that have failed on me. I have the Geek Squad shit, so I just need to get it in there. But they close at 6, and I've been waking up at 5. So I'll try tomorrow. I'm gonna swap my end now that the Hero 9 is out. The pricing of the Hero 8 has gone down, so I'm gonna swap my Hero 7 over into a Hero 8. And I found this chart here of FOV. So something that I'm starting to notice with the drift footage is that I thought that the GoPro had a really. I thought GoPros had like 170, 160, 180 diagonal FOV, but apparently not. The long and short of this right here is that I'm gonna change my FPV lenses on my cinema-ish rigs. I think I'm just gonna end up doing this on all my rigs. But I'm gonna change my camera FPV camera slash lens setup to mimic the field of view of the GoPro Hero 8. Because I'm noticing that in some of the drift footage, it's like the camera is just point. Like, I remember in the goggles having my subject in the bottom of the frame, but then on the GoPro, it's not in the frame at all. And if the Hero, I'm assuming the Hero 7 field of view is very similar to the Hero 8 here that we're looking at, and that would totally kind of explain that. When you're shooting cinematic stuff, don't use Super View, just use Wide. Super View is great for like straight up freestyle FPV, but when you start shooting like subjects, like known subjects that are like a known shape, like a car that's a known rectangle, Super View kind of warps the corner of the frame a little bit, so your rectangular objects can kind of change shapes because of Super View. It just doesn't look right. So yeah, you want to use Wide, and when we look here at the field of view for the Hero 8 on Wide, they use the digital lens is how they yeah. So on Wide, my diagonal field of view is actually 150 here on 4x3, and then on 16x9, the wide field of view is 133.6. So 133 is a little too narrow. I'm not going to go to that. But what's interesting here is this 150, 150 diagonal field of view for the wide setting on 4x3. Yeah, I think you guys know what I'm getting at. I'm going to go to 150 field of view FPV cameras and just force myself to adapt. I know that I'm not going to fly as good with them, and I think I'm going to leave one GoPro session rig on 165, 170 field of view camera setup, which is the Micro Eagle with the RC25G lens. But yeah, that's something that I'm going to be doing. And I wanted to mention that because I feel like I'm not the only person that maybe has an unrealistic expectation of what the GoPro field of view is, right? So yeah, there's a thing. Aethix is here. Damn, where you been, Aethix? All the OG motherfuckers are coming out tonight. What's up, dude? How you been? So yeah, there's the thing. If you guys are at some point gonna start or want to shoot more cinematic stuff, now you know what field of view the GoPro Hero 8 is gonna provide. And that's actually really important, because when you're like, you can th there are some there is a way to put a box in the in your FPV, and that would kind of be the better option. In both Brain FPV and now Betaflight's FPV, there's an option to put a viewfinder rectangle, basically. And then you can move it around, you can make it bigger and smaller. So that's the best way to do it, in my opinion. The best way to do it would be to run like 170 field of view lens and then sit there in Betaflight on each rig, getting the square to be just right. And the square would be there to represent what the GoPro sees. And then when you're flying freestyle, you just ignore the square, and you've got that wider field of view, right? And then when you're flying on, you know, wide, not super view or more cinematically or whatever, you've got your viewfinder square. But the thing to kind of kick this all off is that the Micro Eagle is discontinued, and I'm switching over to nano cameras so that I can get my deck height down even further. The FPV camera has always been, for me, flying the glide frame, the FPV camera was always the tallest point, and it was the thing that basically it was the tallest object in the rig, so it was what determined how high the standoffs were. And that was always kind of a shame because the glide is built to put the flight controller up front here. So basically what Bob did with this frame is he pushed the nose, wait, let me pull this down a little bit. He pushed the nose of the frame out longer because the farther forward you push your GoPro, the less prop that's in view. He had to do that because he wanted to do a true X. He didn't want to go to a squished X. So I've always loved that about this frame. So yeah, he's got it set up with that extra space in the front so that you can put your 20 by 20 flight controller up here. You can put a 20 by 20 or 30 by 30 ESC in the middle. And then in the back here, you've got plenty of space for a 1000 UF capacitor and your receiver and VTX. So up in the front, you've got a 20 by 20 ESC, which is not very tall. In the middle, you've got a 30 by 30 or a 20 by 20 ESC, which is not very tall, right? See what I'm getting at? And in the rear, you've got your communications package that's not all that tall. Going down to 15 millimeter standoffs, and in order to do that, you have to shrink down to the nano cameras. But luckily, the nano cameras are getting really good. The Runcam Phoenix Nano is awesome. But it's 150 field of view and there's no other lens available. The other nano camera that I've got going here is the Caddx Toothless Nano. Same deal, 150 field of view, and I don't know of a What was I talking about? Things? RawPix just posted about cancer, so now my brain just went like, Oh, wider lenses. Yeah, there's no wider lenses available for any of these nano cameras yet. So, but it that sounds like it might be a good thing. RawPix just said, wait, hold on. Let me go back a little bit. RawPix, it looks like RawPix asked Rotorius yesterday about the Ripper. That's pretty awesome. I always wondered if the reason why they never wanted to make it was that nobody like asked about it, right? Like nobody asked them about it. There's no interest in it. So that's cool, RawPix, that you asked them about it. This is what Rotorius wrote to me on Facebook yesterday when I asked him about the Ripper. Ripper family will be available in a few weeks. Well, yeah, I mean, so the Ripper will be available in a few weeks is what I've been told for the last year and a half or so. Ciati's will be the Ripper CB, short for Ciati's Baby, and the OG model will be the Ripper DX, and I think I have at least one pre-production DX kit still here. So the other thing, interesting, that's news to me. I've been asking for a Ripper prototype for a year and a half, so that we can, I've put every bit of thought and effort that I can into it, into text, into Google Doc, and that's where it kind of stopped. So there hasn't been a prototype or anything like that for me to test to make sure that the camera fit, the Runcam Hybrid fits, the Tarsier fits, and that the frame is not going to implode. But then RawPix says, he also said he had to beat cancer and is now trying to keep up with stuff again, including the website and the River Frames. We need to contact him. Alright, yeah, I'll reach out to him one more time. I did not know about that. I would assume that... I wish that he would have told me about that, the cancer thing, but yeah. I'll shoot him another message. I only messaged him a few weeks ago, most recently, though, and I hadn't heard, but whatever. Whatever. I would love for it to get made. I've got a lot of time invested in that frame. So yeah, things, 150 degrees field of view. I'm going to, force myself to fly it and maybe I was crazy flying the wider field of view. Maybe it's better to fly less field of view, although I've done it a million times and I don't like it as much, but that's okay. Maybe the nano cameras will get a wider field of view in the future and then I can go back, but this will be an interesting, New camera angle for the bench. And I can already tell that I'm not going to like it because it's vibrating. Let me see if I can get it to not vibrate as much. Oh, come on. If I put it here, maybe it won't vibrate as much. I'm also trying to get as little of my grundle in the frame as possible. All right, let's see if this vibrates less. Oh yeah, definitely less. Okay, so I'm gonna leave the mount like that, and I'm gonna come in here to the Logitech settings, and I'm gonna zoom this motherfucker. And then the game of keeping shit centered will begin. All right, so let me leave that right like that, and we're gonna just start using the new camera angle, and we'll see how it is. Okay, so I'm gonna pull this over a little bit, and we're gonna test the mic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so that should be just about right. All right, cool. So this is, speaking of FPV Cycle and Bob, this is his first frame. This is the Flow Ride. And this was the very first 5-inch frame I ever built and flew. So it's got a special place in my heart. And then I told Brad, who was flying, Brad McManus, McManus FPV, I told him about this frame and event. He was flying heavier setups, and eventually I was able to convince him to try this frame, and he fell in love with it just like I did. So what I'm building here is actually Brad's Flow Ride. Most of you guys that have been here on Monday nights know that Brad sent a huge box of awesome stuff for the giveaways, which we've been giving away. And in that box of stuff was his old Flow Ride build. And I figured, you know what? I'm going to build this thing. So I have one of these. What the fuck, really? You're going to do me like that? You son of a bitch. This just stripped out hard. Jesus. Yeah, so I have one of these built almost identical. Well, it kind of is identical. The only difference is Brad has always flown these the higher KV 2306 Hype Train motors, and I used to fly the lower KV T-Motor F40 Pro 2s, the 2400 KVs. So there was always... Wow, what the hell is up with the... I never noticed this about these before, but... There's a... What? Why is this so... Why is there so much rotation on this? Well, that's weird. I never noticed these. So these are... I think Foxeer sends these. They are 2 millimeter, which is really nice. They're not 1.5 millimeter headed. I don't know, what the fuck are these called? Camera screws? Yeah, camera screws, that's what they're called. Yeah, and I like them because they're M3 headed rather than being M2 headed, which is really nice. So yeah, this is going to be Brad's. I'm going to finish this up and then send it to him, but the thing that I'm working on right now is the camera is not sitting straight. And that is something that happens from time to time when you use these TPU, camera loop guys, and it's something that you do want to pay attention to because the camera being sideways in here is not going to make you fly better. So always just like when you're using the TPU camera loops, just always kind of hold this up and make sure that the camera is straight in there before you go putting everything back together. You can also kind of look on the bottom. A lot of times the bottom of the frame has like slots cut into it, and then you can just kind of look at the slots and the bottom edge of the camera to see that it's Yeah, to see that it's going well. What's up, Solo? How are you, man? Julian Vincent says, get a Sharpie, put a big red X. I was the last time I had the camera angle like this, I just did it with masking tape. But what's nice is the way I have this set up is the left side cuts off with this Get FPV mat, which is kind of perfect because this is pretty much where I work on this mat. Like I pretty much work right here on the mat usually. So I think this camera placing will be different. You guys though, just if you want to see a close up of something, just let be sure to let me know, because this is not going to be great. When I had the camera here, when I had the camera back here and it was looking like that, I feel like it was good for close-ups, but it wasn't good for anything else. So, yeah, I don't know. Tell me things. Tell me things, people. Tell me if you like this camera angle, if you don't like it, if I my face if you don't like my face, definitely, let me know. Did you just go, oh? Kristen goes, oh no. All right, so one of the problems here is that these TPU loops are not even on the standoffs, so I need to even these up on these front. There we go. Okay, so that's a lot better, and go figure, that has made the camera sit a lot straighter. So yeah, this is the FlowRide frame, and it's got an AIO $30 flight controller ESC all in one. That is sitting up on those little rubber standoff guys, so that it has a little bit of movement to it, a little bit of soft mounting there. I've got a Rush, the really cheap Rush VTX slid under the AIO there, and then I've got the frame built so that the arms are above the base plate, which is not the intended way to build this frame, but the X plate looks nice and strong. So I think that this build should work. This is kind of like a backup rig. It's got like a whole bunch of old parts, a very cheap AIO. So yeah, this is not a rig that like I'm obsessing over the performance of. This is a rig that's like nostalgic and kind of serves the plate. It's kind of like the 5-inch version of a brushed Tiny Whoop, right? It's like all kind of older stuff. It's not gonna perform as good as the new stuff that we've got, but it's a really good. It's just nice to have, right? It's nice to have that backup rig. It's also nice to have something as like a control that shows the progress, right? Like the main idea of this is that every time I fly, I can kind of see what rigs flew like 4 years ago. And that's valuable. It really is, because it's easy to take a lot for granted with the way that these rigs fly. What is this? 18? This is 18 gauge wire. So let me, I usually use 20, but Brad's got 18, so we're gonna go with 18s. Can you guys see when the drawers open? No, not quite. Oh, that feels like a missed opportunity. If I point it down. Oh, it's because it's all zoomed in. That's right. If it's not so zoomed in, I bet you it'll do a better job at that. All right, back to this. Oh, lots of orange in the chat. Here we go. Ruby Tim says I'm on his TV, but he's not gonna be in the chat as much. That's okay. J Drones says, have you tried the Razor? What the hell's the Razor, J Drones? I haven't even heard of that. Aethix says, I love the Caddx Amp for my baby tooth build. Maybe I'll try that one next. Rawpix says, he also said he had to. Oh, yeah, we talked about that. Right, Big Ol' Air says Run Cam Nano. I think he was filling in the blank that my broken brain was leaving. Julian Vincent says get a show. Okay, we got that. Rawpix says if you want, I can send you my conversation with Rotorius on Facebook via Patreon, so you have more details. Finn, no worries on that. Oh, hey Finn, what's up? I didn't connect you, Finn, with Rawpix FPV. Very cool. Don't worry about it, Finn. You were talking to Eckhart, and I've been talking to him for the last year and a half since Rotorius changed hands ownership wise. So I appreciate the offer, but I am good. Solo says Yoda. Frank Nicholas says, why are the bells off the motors? Because Brad sent me 9 different bells, 9 different drip bells, and No, it was because these motors were very dirty, so I wanted to clean the motors. But I also wanted to test all of the bells that he sent to find the one that had the, to find the ones that were the best balanced. And then KD2RDH Larry says, could you turn the mat around so the print is right side up for us? You know, I already thought about that, Larry. I already thought about that. So, A, that is why I am down here. I'm here to cover up the backwards get FPV. My little picture. The other issue is I have taped this mat down. I taped this mat down pretty good because it kept moving around. I can't. Believe me, Larry, I want to, but I cannot rotate this mat around. Plus, if I rotate the mat around, I won't get the good measurements down here. Yeah, I can't. I want to, but I can't. Yeah. I still love you guys, though. That's what's important here. Here we go with some 18 gauge. That one piece is probably enough for both. I appreciate you guys being as crazy as I am. What turkey am I basting? Okay, so for the record, if you guys find one of these AIOs here, for really, really cheap, get it. They're all made by Airbot, and they all kind of suck, but for $30, it's a really good deal. If you get one of these, though, here's the thing. Here's how you don't blow it up. Cut your, So they put these FETs incredibly close to the pads. So what happens is if your exposed bit of the inner strands of the wire for your motor wires are too long, it'll bridge to the FET and it'll blow the AIO up. So there's a very easy solution, and that's just to cut your little exposed wire bits down shorter than you think you should. And then they're gonna fit perfectly on the little pads here. So, yeah, if you see, I've bought 3 of these AIOs now for $30 each, and I don't regret it at all. I've had one of them that let go on a really hard crash, but the other ones have shockingly been have continued to work. So, yeah, I mean, for $30, it's like shit. That's kind of too good of a deal to pass up, which is why I bought a couple of them, and I can't say that I've been disappointed, mainly because I didn't expect them to last, to be totally honest with you guys, but hey, that's as good a reason as any, right? Like, if I'm not disappointed, that's fine. So here we go, just doing a little soldering. This wire is nice and long, so I can hold it by hand without burning the balls out of myself. When they're shorter than this, though, don't do that. And I'm just going to double this over so that I can get to the center and just chop it right down the middle so that I have the maximum amount of length. Yeah, I'm doing this in 18 gauge because that's what all these other wires are, but I actually prefer 20 gauge for motor wires. I don't feel like there's any real loss. I could totally be wrong, but I don't know. Big ol' Air says, drib bells sounds like something that could be avoided by using condoms. It is very similar to the 7-year itch, indeed. Drippy balls, yo. Only the drippiest of bells on this channel. Only the drippiest of balls and the dribbiest of bells on this channel. Don't at me, as the cool kids say. All right, so, and yeah, I did most of the work on this rig last night. When I couldn't sleep last night, I was like, you know what? I'm sick of this rig being half-built. I'm just going to work on it. And it's funny, the AIO makes working on this build like a joke. Because it's like, you wire up the motors, and then like, yeah, I mean, it's just... Although, I don't know. I guess regular builds... The only difference between this and a regular build is the cable that goes from the ESC to the flight control. What the fuck is happening? Why is this fighting me like this? I guess it's not... It's more like symbolically less work, I guess. It allows you to do cool things with the build. Like, the way that I've built this, I wouldn't be able to build any other way, so it's... It lets you go to really low standoffs, which is kind of cool. This setup right now has 15 millimeter standoffs in the center section, and then a 20 millimeter standoff up front for the camera. So the prop line is going to be nice and high because of those 15 millimeter standoffs, and then we've got plenty of space up front for the camera. And I think that I bridged this to the FET. No, I didn't. So with these AIO boards, after you solder up your motors, you have to sit here with the loop, with a 5X loop, and just be like very, very crazy about making sure that you haven't bridged anything. So yeah, just take your time. And do it right, and you'll be good. I'm actually having to come in here and rework this because I didn't get the heat to penetrate all the way down into the pad, into the whole pad. The heat only got half of the pad warmed up, and now we're good to go. I could see it flow and flatten out on that one. We've got that VTX down below. Those wires just kind of come up. For the first time ever, I used so Rush puts a plug on their VTX plug. Oh man, my fucking brain. Oh, the words, they're very difficult. The words are very hard. I just realized how dumb I am. I wired the camera directly to the BCX. I wondered why it was so easy. Yo, bot is here. Fight the drone, punch it. Yo, yo. one more hour to go of warming you bastards up for DJ. Oh, hi.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg died.
Oh, no. Well, she almost got to the end, I guess.
We needed her because, you know, that's not like a hole he's going to fall.
Yeah, but she was going to retire, though.
I didn't think she would. Was she going to?
Yeah.
Was it her health? She died from, like, complications with her cancer.
Oh, man. RBG just died. That's, not great. But I think the plan was, when Biden wins, for her to retire, I believe. So she almost made it. Fuck, man, that's sad. That's somebody who's done more for sanity in this country, than most. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, Ruth Bader Ginsburg. RBG. Damn. That's very sad. Okay, so I, for some reason, wired the camera directly to the... There was, like, this nice little, connector on here that, well, then what the hell is the yellow wire for? Oh, the yellow wire is for, right, for smart audio. I got it. Right. Smart people. Okay, so I need to pull this apart. I'm not gonna have enough. Well, maybe. All right, so let me do this. There's what I'm gonna try to do right now. The white video wire is going directly from the camera to the VTX. So what I'm going to try to do is cut that somewhat in the middle and then just route those to where they need to be, which unfortunately is all the way over here. I was sitting here like, why the fuck are all... Like, how am I only using these three here? Yeah, I don't know. All right, so let's try this. I'm gonna use another piece of wire as a fucking thing to get the length right. Here we go. Okay, so video in is the very first one, and then video out is the third one. Okay, I want to see how far I need to go to the video in. So I'm going to do that by just using another little piece of wire. Okay, so we're gonna basically just like that. So that is roughly, oh wow, and yeah, that's the entire length of this wire. Okay, so I need to do some things. Trying to think of like the easiest way to fix this, and I think I know what that is. I think that means that I'm gonna pull this standoff off, and then well, maybe I can just kind of sneak it out. I need to get the plug on the VTX unplugged, because I'm gonna go in there and swap one of those wires out. But the problem is, I made the power leads on this VTX very, very, very short. More than likely too short. So I'm gonna have to pull this standoff in order to move it. Looks like Spudnik looked it up. Metastatic pancreas cancer. Oh my god.
It's 8 o'clock.
Oh, yeah. Jesus. That's, I have a little bit of a window into pancreas stuff from Jamie, little Stellar Fox, as well as, our little cat here. Yeah, nobody deserves that, man. I don't care what side of the political fence you're on. Nobody deserves that, man. That's sad. That's, man. All right. I just saw that this wire was, like, in a terrible state, so I just wanted to put the soldering iron on it while I was looking at it. All right. So, I've got this standoff off because it's got the antenna, and that just that gives me access to this little plug header, which I need to pull the video wire out of, and I'm gonna replace it. Well, actually, I didn't really need to do that. Yeah, no, it was smarter to do it this way. Okay, cool. So let's get the very last wire pulled out of this little plug header here. So, oh, this is gonna be a hard one. This is a pain in the ass when the rig isn't built. This is gonna be about 10 times harder since I've got all these things like in the way here. I wonder if I can just kind of like push it out though. Let's see if I can just push it out. Holy shit, I pushed it out! Whoa, that was way easier than trying to pull it out. Go ahead, come on. Come on, chat. This is me. I've presented you with something. Come on. Come on. Come on, chat. Don't fucking let me down. If you have to rewind, you can rewind, but I've presented you with something that I expect you to, to say the thing that you should be all saying right now. Fuck! I'm not gonna, it's on you guys. You gotta figure it out. I gave you guys the golden, I don't know. That's what she said, you fuckers. There it is! Buck got it! Jesus, come on. Collective, I am disappointed. I am happy that Bot got it though. That's that makes me feel warm inside. Hey Bot. I don't know. I thought maybe like by the time I got done saying it, I would I'd think of something cool to say. What are you doing on your stream tonight, bro? What's the fucking plan? I put my third Cinewhoop battery ever up into Bot's patron only video channel, an idea that I think I stole from him. If I didn't steal it from him, I'm sure I stole it from someone else. But yeah, you guys should also be on Bot's channel. Because if you don't, I will cut your face. And it's just another great place to for greatness. I guess, I don't know, man. I guess Friday nights just aren't my fucking thing because I cannot get my smooth fucking brain to say words that make any real semblance of sense. here in on Earth. But I don't know. I mean, you guys are still here. Hot and wet. There it is. Aethix knows what's up. Bot invented a trick challenge. Oh, invent a trick challenge. Playing baller-ass Patreon videos. Bot says, I think I invented it? Hell yeah. See that? Steal things, people. If you can't think of your own good ideas, just steal other people's ideas. Blind Luck says, what AIO are you using there? Blind Luck, I don't even know. My guess would be that it's a Sunrise Cicada. But that being said, it doesn't really matter. All of these AIOs are all made by Airbot, so regardless of you know, what manufacturer they say on the tin, it doesn't, that's not, that there's, that might not actually be the menu, it's not the actual manufacturer, they're all made by Airbot, so if you see one of these AIOs for really cheap, just snag it. It's just like a, it's just kind of perfect to build a little backup rig with that you never fly but is always there. This is the backup rig that I'm building for Brad. I have my own version that's identical. It's so nice to have it. Like a couple times when Jamie's been like, fuck, I don't have any 5-inch rigs flying, I'm able to just be like, hey, let me send you one. Like, it's a rig that I literally never fly. Like, let me send you this. It's just super, super, super nice to have a backup rig that you never use, which I know is like an insane, that's an insane thought, but, I don't know. It is nice to have. The other thing that I make sure to do is when I'm flying this backup rig, just, I kind of like, don't crash it, because if I'm flying it, I don't have anything else that flies, so it's kind of a natural, whatever. And that's important because this is a long since discontinued rig. So if I go smashing the shit out of this and breaking an arm, I think between Brad and I, we've got one arm left. So yeah, that's not a good thing. But yeah, I don't know. That's my suggestion. Take an old frame and build a super, super backup rig that you never fly. But you will end up flying it because shit happens. And then you can fly it. We're talking some shit now. Build it so that you can fly it, guys. Build it and then don't fly it. Meatwad Fairy says, I'll light one up for you on behalf of your scrambled mind. Thank you, Meatwad. Maybe that would help. Hold on. Be right back. Hold on. Let me give you guys something. Here's what I've been working on. Here's some things that I've been working on that you guys can watch. It'll probably play really bad and be unviewable, but, you know, you guys are probably used to that by now. Here's some bullshit. I'll be right back. Oh my god, what? Why? Why? Jesus fucking Christ. This is what happens when you let quad pilots on a fucking oval. More of that. Jesus, that noise. I like the way quads sound. Ah, shit. Everything's fine. Don't at me. Okay. Nothing going on here. Okay. So, all right. I'm going to try to push this little fucker out. There you guys go. And unto you, chat, I just said, I'm going to try to push this fucker out. And unto you, chat, unto you. Oh, Spud, that's not going to happen. Free Lojo gets it. There we go. There we go. Yeah. My parents watch this shit sometimes, Spud Nick. I can't do that. I'm just assuming that they're not watching right now. And if they are, well then, you know, I'll find out sometime. Okay, so this is not the right, this is not the right fucking plug. This is just a big old shit show. I usually get these plugs into the right, into the right little boxes, but this time I didn't. I think I have one of these plugs that is all fucking jacked up that I can rip apart. I've got the wrong ones in here, though. What the fuck? Come on, man. Great. Do that, Nose. Yeah, I was really, you know, I was just sitting here earlier. I was like, you know what I miss? I miss my Nose being a fucking asshole. And, pretty much just completely annihilating this fucking everything. Oh, for Christ's sakes. Meatwad Fairy. Sputnik says fearless. Oh, man, I used to know that whole, I used to know that whole Yoda speech. Fear leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering. Suffering. Okay, look. I might have just fucking pioneered a new way of getting nosebleeds. Let's see if I can push it out a second time in a row. So here's what I did. I went under the corner and I lifted the plastic up a little bit, and then I just went, nah, it doesn't work. I totally got lucky with that first one. I'll try one more time, lift it, and push it. Now, see, it doesn't work. Now, you gotta pull them out. You gotta pull your PUD. There's, you can't push it out. That was a ridiculous idea. Yeah, you gotta pull your PUD, guys. I'll wait. Go ahead and go pull your PUD, and I'll be here waiting. Man, is that fucking weird. That is a... it's like a very rapey thing to say. There it is. Sputnik's got it. Let's see if I can push it out. Oh my god, fuck you, Nose. I'm gonna fucking cut you off and eat you, you piece of shit bastard. Fear leads to hate. Hate leads to cutting your fucking nose off. With an X-Acto knife. Okay, so now I've got this little shit slap. I can shit slap this little shit slap into this shit slap, and I should have probably called this like late night curse fest stream, because I don't know. Bot's a fucking bad influence playing that that angry Spider-Man song at the beginning of every fucking stream. Every time I hear that, I just want to scream, fucking march in the goddamn streets for what's right. Ugh. God, it pisses me off that song's from fucking Spider-Man, though. It's too fucking hard to be from Spider-Man. Spider-Man's not that hard, come on. Unless they finally fucking let Donald Glover be Spider-Man. Donald Glover for Spider-Man 2020, goddammit. Ugh. That's the only situation where that song should have been in there. Fight me if you think I'm wrong. No, don't. That's not very nice. Oh god, I gotta push things forward now. Right. Miles Spider-Man. Who's Miles Spider-Man, bot? Oh god. Bot, did you hear my the intro song? Is it not gonna play? It's not gonna play. Oh, because it's over. Let me hit you guys a little bit more. So the intro song was Kavinsky, and I'm gonna give you guys a little bit more. Oh wait, no, I can just play this straight up for you guys. Here. Oh no, I can't. Never mind. Check out the fucking mood on this one. I'm trying to figure out how to use the word mood, guys. I see all the kids using it. So I wanna... Sometimes I try to be, like, as old man as possible, in case you guys haven't fucking caught on yet. But, yeah, I don't know. The word mood is stupid, but I'm trying to use it as a way to point out its stupidity. It's not stupid. It's not stupid. It's just what the kids are saying, and I hate the kids. At least I said the kids. At least I didn't say I hate kids. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not a kid person. I very much doubt that I will ever have children for a number of different reasons. You guys can probably barely not hear me, which is a good thing. What movie is this from? Drive? If I had to guess, this would be from Drive. Yep, look at that. Okay, so you guys know this one. Let me keep going. Try to give you guys something new and good. Mike Bergman is here. Thank you for sending those. You are certainly welcome. Haven't gotten them or even know where they are, but thank you. more people should be like Mike Bergman. The line of thinking that he just had is perfect. That's the way you should all be. Everybody take a lesson from Mike. Everybody wants to be like Mike. You guys remember... actually, most of you guys are old enough. Because for some reason I've got a very old audience. It's because I'm so unhip, I'm sure. But, you guys probably remember, I Wanna Be Like Mike, the song I Wanna Be Like Mike. Yeah, right? That OG Michael Jordan shit. OG Nike ads, motherfuckers! Sorry, guys, there's a lot of rage. Bardwell was right, man. I'm an angry dude. But, I don't know. You guys choose to stay and listen to me freak out, so... It's, you're as guilty as I am! Okay, I'm doing something completely, like, full-on crazy person right now. I'm like, being crazy about how these wires twist around. So just give me a second. This will be over in a second. Let me just be crazy, and then this wire will be perfect. There we go. Okay. All right. Got the crazy out. Now we can move on. Plug this back in. This is one of Brad's favorite analog cameras here too. This is the Runcam Sparrow Micro Pro. One of the few first micro cameras that Runcam made with M12 lenses. M12 refers to the fucking fuck! I forgot to put it under the thing. M12 refers to the Which way did I have it going under this? You son of a bitch. M12 refers to the thread of the lens. God damn it. I think I'm just going to leave it on top of that. I have issues with cable routing. Like, if the routing of the cables is not perfect, I'm not happy. And when I'm not happy, people die. So, yeah. We don't want that. What's happening in the chat? I'm just, like, as I just vomit the English language. as I just vom words out into the universe on a platform that actually records you and does things like, Never mind. Okay, so now I gotta work on my mood some more and plug this guy in. So I just need to plug this guy in. This won't be... This new camera angle sucks, doesn't it, guys? I feel like it sucks. I feel like you guys can't see what the fuck I'm doing. Especially because the quality of the stream is so low. I feel like, yeah, this isn't going to be a winner. But, you tell me. Maybe you guys just come to hear me say stupid things. Come on, man, stay in there, you little jackass. Yeah, there we go. That's right, you better stay in there, you little jerk. Since nothing else seems to work with these stupid little JSC connectors, you may as well just try to talk to them. Try to reason with them, you know? Okay, so I'm gonna rotate this downwards. No. I'm gonna rotate this upwards. Mike, the motor bells are removed because I had to clean these motors because Brad got them really dirty. What if I try zooming this out? Let me try zooming it out. To see you punch the quad, Julian says. License to Drive says, last week they broadcast from a hot air balloon over Turkey. Who? Who did? Oh, your previous thing. Do you know about the YouTube channel called... No. Sir Clay, I guess that's called? Company that sets up... great DJs and amazing places. Oh, License, you told me about that once, and I checked it out, and it was really good. I didn't see the hot air balloon one, though. I think I subscribed. Do me a favor, send me a link. I want to make sure I subscribed. And then Larry says, it's hard to not look at the train wreck. That was funny. Big Willie built a Cinerat. This is a tank, 350 grand, 3-inch. Can't wait to freestyle it. Very cool. B-Man says, what's going on? Not a lot, man. Just getting everybody warmed up for bot at 9 o'clock. We got 40 more minutes. all right. Caught up. Meatwad Fairy, not caught up. Says, can't wait to build 2508. I'm off for now. iRacing sessions. You lucky bastard, Meatwad. Freeload just is repainting JST characters is fun. 17th floor is the Super Virgin. And Travis has missed so much. You didn't miss much, Travis. what else can I give you guys? This is a hot jam. This is an 8-minute long hot jam. All right, here we go. I am in Atlanta, blind luck. Alpharetta, right outside of the city. Okay, so I need to figure out which direction I want to... Or I can just stop being, like, a level 10 lunatic and just be, like, a level 8 lunatic and just rotate this fucking thing down and plug it in because it makes absolutely no difference. Ah, that's not true. It doesn't not make a difference. but the difference that it makes is slim to nil. So stop being crazy and just plug the fucking thing in. Aaron Ciotti, you complete lunatic. The first step, though, is admitting it, guys. So, you know, step one, done and dusted. I love building really tight builds like this until I have to, like, take them apart in any way, shape, or form. Although that's one of the things I really like about the Glide, is that you can build it really tight, and it's still easy to maintain. This build, on the other hand, not so much. But this is kind of like a unique one-off build. If I was building more of these, I would change some things. What the fuck? Go in there, you goddamn douche! Like, I get it. I don't get it. Why won't it? You were just plugged in here, motherfucker. Am I trying to plug it in upside? Oh, the fucking pin's bent. You! Oh, okay. Alright, so I bent the pins, but not bad. Because like a complete jackass, this song is about to fucking blow your face off, by the way. I hope your face is glued on, because it's coming the fuck off in a second. I gotta give you guys full fucking stank volume on this. This, listen to this. I mean, that shit's not ridiculous. Oh god, I love this song. I love this band. I love everything. I love you guys. I love balls. No, that's not true. Keith Drones with a $4.99 super chat. He says, Serenity Now. That makes no sense. This is angry music. B-Man 80 says, what's going on at 9 o'clock? I am stopping this stream, and we're going to all go watch Bot Grinder, which you guys should all be doing every Friday night at 9 o'clock anyway. B-Man says, I wonder if this is what I sound like when I'm working on the bench. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but... June Logo says, yo, what's up? I bought the new DJI Diatone Roma 5-inch. I can't wait. I am unfamiliar with that one. I will look that up in a bit, though. B-Man says, B-Man is jamming out. He likes that song. And then Carbon Cage is here. Frank Nicholas says, it's okay to love balls, especially if they're attached to yourself. That's true. Tiago says, Stu is live. Oh, shit. That makes me want to jump off so that we can go watch Stu. Well, just bounce back and forth. Just somebody go tell Stu that... which one, 17th floor? Their new 2004 VY and their 1504 and a half VYs are kind of God's gift to motors right now. So if those are the ones that you're talking about, then big fucking thumbs up. It looks like Brother Hobby's VY line is going to be nice and smooth and not notchy, not coggy, etc., etc., etc. And that's huge. That's a rarity for us to get motors that are even remotely smooth. So yeah, there's that. I have not, Eric Allen, but a bunch of us have been talking about the newbie drone flows lately. I just talked to E-Rod, yo. He's one of the new Rotor Riot pilots. Him and I have been chatting back and forth for quite a while. And he ran the newbie drone flow 2306 and a halfs earlier this year, and he said they're great. So for $10 a motor, yeah. I was a little bit worried because they're Frank Nicholas and I were talking about them through email, and he'd said that they're extremely notchy. I did a little bit of research and found out that they're using an even more powerful magnet. It's an N55 magnet, which I didn't even know existed, but it does. And it's actually kind of an interesting magnet. It deals with heat better than N52s, which is a really good thing. And I talked to E-Rod about any... vibration issues from them being so notchy, and he said he didn't have any. He's not flying them anymore, but he said when he was flying them, they were great. And we were actually talking about the price, like, how the fuck? So it looks like those new... I haven't flown them personally. Frank offered to send me a set, but I've got so many goddamn motors that I need to test. I had to say no for the moment. I don't know, man. It looks pretty fucking good. They look pretty fucking good. I'm gonna be a complete lunatic and pull this apart again. Because I don't quite love how this, wire is being routed. There's a better way to route this wire. I don't know. I'm a crazy person, so I do things 800 times so that they're absolutely perfect. Oh, we're going straight to the sword? Are you kidding me? There's gonna be a fucking fatality. I can't leave this song on. It'll get too angry in here. Hold on. I gotta turn this off. Oh, the fucking sword. Ugh. I'm gonna put Elder back on. A little bit more chill than the sword. If I start listening to the sword, it's... The squad's gonna get the shit beaten out of it. So I really want this wire to go down, which you guys can't see, because this is the worst camera angle in the fucking world. There's a chance that you guys can't see anything that I'm doing, and it really doesn't matter, so... Is that true? Can you guys never really see what I'm doing, and you just like you don't want to burst my bubble, so you're just like, yeah, that looks good, dude. It's okay if the answer is yes. It's okay. I'm cool with that. All right, so I need to just pry this fucker away. because I'm going to really just jam this in here. There's going to be no room, and it's probably going to cut the wire at some point. That's how I like to do my builds. Tight and unserviceable. Just the way I like my women. Sorry to any women watching. I'm usually not such a fucking pig. But when in Atlanta, be a pig, I guess. All right, get out of the way, VTX. I need to sneak this cable past. It's the connector that's being a bitch right now. The cable will go right by, but the connector is bigger than the little three little friends here. Get in there! Come on, it's so close. There it goes. There it goes. Go! Oh! Back to square one. No. It's in there a little bit. God damn it. Build it small and build it tight. Get... Oh my god. This is... Right now is like... It's like working on a micro right now. This is full-blown working on a micro frustration of like... My fingers are... I have skinny little fingers, so when I think my fingers are too fat, there's a fucking problem. Get in there. There it is. I got it. And my voice only cracked a little bit. Oh, come the fuck on! I have some hardware. I have some tools coming from Amazon. I've had some tool failures in the last couple weeks, and so I went on Amazon and I got some new tools. Is that not the fucking most boring thing that anyone has ever said to you? Is that not the most boring thing you've ever heard? Man, I am hungry as shit, too. I don't think I've eaten anything yet today. But, I mean, I only woke up 3 hours ago, so... Oh, my God. Get the fuck out of there! Pull. Just pull. Pull. What? Who am I saying that to? Myself? What the fuck is that? What... I knew I shouldn't have done this. As soon as I started to do this, I was like, nope, this isn't going to go smooth. This is going to take 20 minutes. Oh. But I did it anyway, because I'm a shitbag. There we go. All better. It was worth it, guys. It was totally worth it. Not fucking worth it. It's never worth it when I do this. It never is. That's the inconvenient truth, is that every time, and like, I can kind of notice it now, but I still can't do anything about it. I'm still powerless to the craziness. All right, so I'm gonna be crazy again. I'm gonna do this little thing that I keep wanting to do, which is to put these wires together and then spin it up like that. Okay, so that looks way better than it needs to. See, and that's really it right there. That's it. Way better than it needs to. It is kind of cool, though, when I take pictures of shit and it looks all pristine and perfect, and that does make it kind of worth it, but it's still not. It's still not worth it. Don't be like me. Be, try to just, in anything you do in life, just think, like... think, like, is there a less Ciati FPV way of doing this? That'll take you far in life. I can guarantee it. Is there a less crazy way of doing this? Just think that a lot. If you have similar issues to me. Got an issue? Here's a tissue. Alright, so I'm gonna now bring this all the way back there for total crazy. And all the way back here. We've got, so this is what a rando stream looks like for anybody who hasn't been on one of my rando streams before. It's just a fucking disaster. It's there's not even a semblance of like common sense or you know, wanting to make a good live stream. It's just me, man. It's just fucking me in the raw. So you're gonna hear things you don't like. You're gonna hear things that you do like. And I take no responsibility for how many of each you I needed to send a quick text. Hold on, before I forget. Oh god, no, what's happening? Oh, Christ. Oh, boy. Fuck. Why do I find myself saying fuck you to you so often, Larry? But fuck you. Larry says the normal streams are so polished. Oh, you son of a bitch, you. It's funny because it's true. What did I want to, okay, let's see. All right, hold on. Gotcha. Okay, hold on. All right, hold on. Okay. There we go. Hold on a second, guys. Gotta put somebody in their place. And okay, cool. Sorry for that, guys. I am a bad streamer. What's up, Speedy Turtle? How the hell are you? Okay, I need to come back over here and keep doing the things that I'm supposed to be doing. So I think I can put this... I got that shit plugged back in. I got the cables routed in the same way that an actual crazy person that would. Crazy person would, rather. I think I can now put this standoff back on here. So, let's get this little guy threaded up and in here. And... okay, now I need to hold this goddamn standoff in place. So, if you guys ever see for sale, hex standoffs rather than the knurled standoffs, do yourself a favor and get a shitload of them. They are so much better than the knurled ones. Being able to throw a wrench onto a standoff to tighten or loosen it versus having to use a pair of knurled needle-nose pliers that fucking obliterate the surface of the thing. Yeah, it's pretty great. So, do it. Get yourself some hex standoffs if you can. I remember Ready-Made RC used to have them, but I don't think they have them in the right sizes anymore because basically I think I bought all of them. But yeah, there are other places that have hex 20mm, 25mm standoffs, and yeah, you should get them. They're good. Okay. And just make sure that this camera's sitting straight. It keeps wanting to shift around. I think it's because of these goddamn... I don't love these TPU jib jabs. There it is, the duct tape suggestion by Weirdo with a Skateboard. Hell yeah. Yeah, Mike, I tried to buy as many of those as I could so that nobody else could have them. So this, the camera zoomed out is terrible, right, guys? We want zoomed in. We want that. This way you guys have some chance of seeing what the fuck I'm doing. I'm assuming, right? You tell me. Okay, so video in is on the front here. So let's do video in first with, for really no good reason at all, this white wire. And I think I'm just going to snake it under there. I think I'm just going to stuff it on in there. See how that goes. Yeah, okay. And I'm going to give it a little bit of extra, but not a lot. And we're going to go choppy, strippy, and flippy. All the pads on these AIOs are absolutely minuscule. So when you're building one of these, just always, like, when you strip a wire, strip, like, almost nothing off. Just strip it, like, the tiniest little bit. Ooh, my hands are shaky. Homeboy is hungry. And the soldering iron cooled itself down. What do we got? 15 more minutes. Cool, I can wait 15 more minutes. Need soda caps. Soda caps for what? Speedy Turtle says they make pliers that have a rubber nose to hold those. I just put shrink wrap over the nose of pliers to do the same thing. Alright, caught up. Good. No! Not caught up. Where do we skateboard? Canny few things. Canny few things first. How's it going? Second, can I put a cap on wires? Solders to the pad, or does it have to be direct? No, you can run it off of... I actually hate doing it like this. I hate having the capacitor directly on the pads because it just fucking breaks off. And that's what I'm waiting for. As soon as this setup here breaks off, I will replace it with wires, and I'll just figure out... Actually, I won't, because I'm sending this to Brad, so he'll have to deal with it, but... yeah, I really don't like the capacitor sitting up like this. I really prefer to do a waffle cap. W-A-F-L cap is an excellent little piece that makes it easy to hook wires up to a capacitor. And then you can, drop your capacitor in a better usually a better protected spot. And you won't have to worry about it breaking off. Alright, so there's video in. And now we just need video out, which is going to run up from the other side here. I'm going to give it... So that's tight. I'm going to just back it off like that much. That's probably a good amount. And away we go. Strip the tiniest little bit off that I possibly can. And let's see what we got. Not to brag or anything, but I didn't stream the other day because I was too busy making a quick little for fun edit for T-Pain with one of his new unreleased songs, which I can't show you because I'm not going to be the guy that leaks somebody's stuff, because that's just not cool, man. Don't be that guy, especially if you ever want to have any kind of a working relationship with that person again. But yeah, that was pretty fucking cool, man. I just continue to be blown away by what a cool dude T-Pain is. Just an awesome guy. I wish all celebrities like that. Fuck that. I wish all people were just the way that he is. Doing shit in real life, I call bullshit. Maurer's back. What's up, brother? You got a keyboard this time, or are you still slumming it on a television? All right, so now we're gonna go and wire these rear nine minutes. Let's see. Carbon Cage is debating whether or not to turn his monitor right side back up. I say keep it upside down. Fuck it. All right, so I'm gonna cut this down just a little bit. So I don't think I'm gonna be able to finish this before we hop off and go watch Bot Grinder. So maybe what I'll do is pull his stream up and give you guys audio from his stream, because it's like understood between us streamers that we won't stomp on each other's little time slots. So yeah, just in case you guys are interested in seeing me finish this, I am gonna leave my stream up for a little bit, but I expect to see the majority of you guys go over and watch some Bot. All right, big old wire. Let's get you tinned and tacked. I'm weirdly stingy with solder, so I'll sit here and use this stupid little piece that I just found on the workbench instead of being a semi-intelligent human being and just cutting myself a fresh piece from right over there. Not even far. But I never claimed to be not crazy, guys, so kinda have to expect it, right? Is that how it works? If you don't say that you're not gonna be crazy, then it's allowed. Okay, next one. Next, Juan. Speedy Turtle. Have a good night, brother. Get your ass over there and watch some Bot. Get you some Spider-Man song. All right, so I'm going to run these cables so that they sit right next to each other. Mainly because the only problem with these AIOs is that you've got big, thick battery wires connected to a connected to the PCB that has your gyro on it, and that's really not a great thing. You want as little connected to the PCB that the gyro is on, so that the gyro can move around as much as possible. So we're not doing a good job of that here, but that's okay. Because as long as you give some good slack on these motor wires, it ain't too bad. It's less than ideal, but again, we're building a backup rig, right? Like, we're not, this isn't our main rig. I would never recommend one of these AIOs to, like, a main rig that you guys are gonna fly. They're not durable enough for that, is really the long and short of it. I mean, realistically, this isn't that much cheaper than a normal build. And like, so like, this is kind of stupid. But, I mean, I'm allowed to do stupid things. They came for the quality content. I don't know why they stayed. They stayed for the confusion. they came for micros, they stayed for the confusion. There is my new channel motto. Or I could do something like, Steve for the, with how often I, like, talk shit, I could do something like, they stayed for the, what's the syndrome, when you're held in captivity? Fuck me, God damn it. Oh! Really? I was just trying to remove the time. Stockholm Syndrome. They came for the micro content. They stayed due to Stockholm Syndrome. Okay, this... Get off of there! There we go. Okay. Stop. Weirdo, you spelled that in the most insane way I think I've ever seen, but I like it. So, like, right now, for example, you guys can't see anything that I'm doing, can ya? Do you care, though, I guess, is the real question? Like, is it... just like 99% audio and the video is just whatever? Because I've heard a lot of you guys say that you just like listen to the stream. God damn it, are you kidding me? This isn't even close to being long. You mother. I mean, like, not even close. And yet I soldered it on there. Come on, man, we're hot. I know we're not wet, but we're hot. Come on. Get off of there. Jesus. All right, I gotta grab some more 18 gauge. It's acting a little weird. We stayed because we don't have a choice. I came to watch you say words. Horribly dyslexic. Oh man, I didn't mean to make fun of your dyslexicness. I wasn't making fun. I genuinely enjoyed the phonetic spelling. B-Man says we came to hear you vomit words. Julian Vincent is just staring at the antenna. Loyal, don't judge me. Live my life like a submarine. Watch, listen at work. Such a nice looking antenna. Oh yeah, look at that, it's just the antenna. Wow. There you guys go. Is that better? That's better. Now you can still not see what the hell I'm doing. Didn't I have a little bit of extra? No. Oh, it's 9 o'clock. Okay. Hold on. I gotta put bot on. YouTube.com. Subscriptions and... Alright, you guys are gonna get my audio mixed with bot's audio. We're gonna see how this works. I'm gonna go like that. What the hell? No, that's not at all what I wanted. I want the bigger viewer, bro. Theater mode. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Theater mode. I'm gonna pull this over like this. I'm gonna kill this. And... Alright, cool. I think the audio should come out. Oh, thanks, y'all, man. It's nice of you. Rudo says, read my chat. You'll be a linguistics expert in no time. Would you go as far as to say that I would, if I read your texts, your... Would you go as far as to say, weirdo, that if I read all of your chats, I'll become a cunning linguist? What good timing. Cunning linguists, unite. Here we go. Mark Spatz is here. Everybody say hi to UAV Tech. He's going to start a live stream of my live stream, live streaming bots live stream. I'm in. You won't, Mark. Mark, are you doing office hours tomorrow morning? Ooh, he was going hard there. I saw it. Did you guys see it? I saw it. All right. Let me finish this up so that I can end this stream and we can all watch bot in peace. Stream circle. It's the streamer version of a circle jerk. It's the stream circle. Is this an 18 gauge? I can't tell, but it's a fucked up piece of wire, so it's going away. Sunday's doing it. What's inappropriate, weirdo? Jesus, if I made weirdo with a skateboard say something's inappropriate, shit must be real inappropriate. I must be doing something right. I don't know about you guys, but I fucking am. Alright. Is this long enough? Yeah, this one's long enough. Here we go. Alright, we're good. Y'all, man, you're missed. You haven't been. That's true, y'all, man. I haven't seen you in a hot minute. It's hard for me to. There's a lot of you guys, so it's hard for me to keep track of your whereabouts. Of who's been around, who hasn't been around. But I'm trying, man. I try. That's all I can do. Who misses Yaw Man? Anybody? Nobody? Alright. How dare you? Keith Drones' aim is improving. What are you aiming? What are you aiming at? Oh, here he comes. Ooh, there he is. Hey.
Beer stream.
Alright, so I need your guys' help to mix this. So, yeah. Help me mix this. Is bot loud enough?
I thought I fixed this.
Am I too loud? Help me.
And... It was this... No, not that.
Somebody go over and tell bot that he needs to stream me streaming him streaming me streaming him at some point tonight.
It broke.
Oh, wait, no. We have to do it soon because I'm going to be done with this in a minute.
Can you hear me? This thing is fucking broken or something.
No, you're good, bot.
It's working now. It wasn't working on my end.
Well, you guys ever talk to your you guys ever talk to me as if I can hear you?
It's been working the whole time, you told me? Well, that's embarrassing because I was just yelling about... welcome. Did you hear the thing? Did you hear the intro? Was I like, welcome?
Bot can be louder. Okay, cool. Thanks, guys.
Well, okay. Let's get this.
Oh, wait. No, I can't do it like that.
I just got back from camping. A beautiful weekend at Pincho State Forest or some shit. I was looking at stars, y'all. I was fucking getting bit by mosquitoes.
What?
I was
Daniel, I did not see that. That's Daniel, do me a favor, message me about that because I'm gonna forget. And that sounds absolutely amazing. Hopefully it'll be
with that 420 donate right off the bat.
We play together.
Super Deluxe, let's start this Friday off right. You are correct. All donations tonight will go towards Super Mario 3D All Stars.
Tiago only shouts no audio.
Just came out, and I want a little shot of nostalgia, so I want to play me some Super Mario fucking 64 and shit. I'm excited. I'm not excited about Mario Sunshine. If you're excited about Mario Sunshine, you're lying.
If you're excited about Mario Sunshine, get the fuck out.
Unless that was your favorite game. But that's okay. There's nothing wrong with it. And let you enjoy your favorite game. But I want some Mario 64 remastered and all that shit. So that's what, just so everybody knows, that's what all donations will be going towards tonight. We're going to be playing some videos. We're going to be giving away challenge coins. This is going to be so fucking great. Let me say hi to everybody. I love, my favorite part is saying hello to all the beautiful people on the stream.
Here we go.
Right off the bat. So what's up, John Davis? Yeah, Boyd, Maddie, Blunstead, Raider.
Yeah, Steve, Boyd.
Super Deluxe, Carbon Cage.
Now Miles, we get to see up? Who's been fucking Apple cheating on me and hanging out over there.
My good friend, Old Gravy Legs, Maggie Mayhem, hello. Julian Vincent, Marcel, Robert, how you doing there?
Y'all, man's very confused.
With some new friend, Billy Hackett, Huggin, FPV, Swift Duck, FPV, Chris, FPV, Sub Bunny, K2DTH. Mr. fucking Larry, Chuck Toast, what's up? And Zorro. We'll be hearing from Zorro in a little bit, so if you like hearing Zorro talk about things, stick around, because we got something special planned for that one. I am not wearing a blue shirt at board. This is black. It might be coming through blue. This is my FPV crate t-shirt. I wore my FPV crate shirt camping, because it was Trump territory like a motherfucker. Let me tell you that. We're camping up in the hills, right?
Oof.
We don't need to get nothing political, but I need a neutral t-shirt I could fucking wear because I fear for my life. So I wore my FPV crate shirt. I feel like unless a bunch of quad box fans live there, then we wouldn't have any problems. Oh, Will Brown, donate. Thank you so much, Will Brown. I saw your text, by the way, and I'm extremely excited. You can definitely, Bot Grinder will do things. Or what the fuck ever. Ciotti is streaming right now. Oh, shit, I was watching the Ciotti stream before I jumped into this stream here. So thank you so much, Thiago Ramos. I appreciate that. I hope Ciotti's stream is going well. I was really enjoying it. Ciotti, if you don't know, Ciotti streams certain days, and I don't keep a schedule. I just am always on YouTube, so I see when he's there. So, go watch Ciotti on the days he streams, because his streams are great. He just builds, he gives shit away, watches videos, and he's an entertaining guy, if you know Ciotti. You know he's entertaining, so I can definitely recommend his live streams. Did I even get water? I went downstairs to get water, and I didn't fucking bring it up here. Well, get ready for me bitching about water for a fucking hour on the goddamn stream. Thank you so much, also, to Rotor Ranger for the donate, too. Thank you, everybody. And Remy Tam. I should pull up Ciotti's stream real quick. All right. Let's go ahead. And I was going to do something else, but if y'all want to see Ciotti's stream, then I guess we can go do that. Let's head on over to the tube. And we'll pull up Ciotti's stream. Let me add a thing. Where's the goddamn thing? I may not know how to do this fast as quick.
Just go to YouTube, Botsy.
Okay, cool, yeah.
You got it.
Let's go. What's Ciotti doing? He's streaming? Look at him. Look at this guy streaming.
Is he gonna notice that I'm streaming him?
Watching me.
There he goes.
Come on, YouTube, motherfucker. Can we talk to each other with a 40-second delay, Ciotti?
Ooh. Okay.
Ciotti.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
I'm good.
Notice that I'm streaming him.
There he goes.
Come on, YouTube.
Oh, this is bad. We're gonna do this for a while, aren't we?
Hi, Ciotti.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
The delay's not that bad.
this is so much. This is too much for fucking me. I don't know if I can handle this.
Should we just do this all night, bot?
Is,
oh, this is bad. We're going to do this for a while, aren't we?
Is also UAV features...
The delay's not that
oh,
bad.
Oh, yeah, let's
okay,
bring...
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah,
bring
yeah.
Going?
We'll go...
Can we just do this all night?
Let's have a menage a trois.
Let's go for a...
Yeah, very, very cool stuff.
Let's just do everybody all at once.
Oh, yeah,
all
let's bring... Yeah.
This is going to be a little... I'm going to freak out.
Let's have a menage a trois.
There we go. Let's watch all the streams at once. God damn it. Get me off of there. Is everybody freaking out yet?
Wait, can I play two
out.
Things at once? Is there a way to do that?
I would have to dip, Ciani. This
oh,
is too
shit.
Much for me. I got shit to do. I would like to thank Ciani for coming on the stream tonight via his stream.
Can I play two things at once? Is there a way to do
it? What's the matter with us?
New window, my man. New window.
Shit.
I'm going to have to hang up.
I just thought I'd jump on again.
Oh, shit.
Plus, I've been playing
okay,
Flight Simulator 2020.
Lot.
Mate, don't need to do Flight
Uh-oh,
Simulator.
Look at that screen. Why the fuck would you look at my fucking screen like that? Y'all, holy sorry I put you through that. Please delete this.
It was fun. All right, now I gotta finish up. Oh, it's getting hot as fuck.
That was a great way to start. Ciani is fucking. I like how you immediately understood what we're going from there. But
oh, that was fun. All right.
I just wanted to cough real quick.
I just wanted to cough real quick. That's the solution right there.
Well,
I love it.
I want to go back and do that more, but I feel like we're just going to be stuck. Me and Ciani can do that fucking all day. Maybe we should do a double stream sometime. Let me know. Let me know the comments of my stream and the comments of Ciani's stream.
Yeah.
Do like a double
same. Do you guys want that?
Stream sometime because I would totally be down. We can figure out the fuck that goes.
Just like
so
total
said,
shit show.
This weekend, right? I went camping. It was beautiful. Did a bunch of cool stuff, and I brought my tiny little drone.
I know you
I
guys
want
that. I don't even know why I bother. I know that you guys want that.
Anything at all. But I'm addicted to FPV, so I brought my little thing that I built. Where is it? This one. This is the little like 3-inch with the GoPro decased thing that I built. Right. All right. Yeah. Remember that thing? I made a video about it, and I flew around in public, and it was super fucking fun. So I made that thing, and I brought that. We will totally double stream sometime. That was a weird ass 3-way stream there. I brought my little fucking drone.
The delay wasn't that bad though.
One
weirdly.
Shot really bad. There's this trail.
I have mine set on like ultra low latency. Maybe if we both did that.
The windows of my car and then around the campsite. And I thought it was going to be so cool. And it took me like 2 tries to go through the window without crashing. This is the one where I didn't crash. But then I immediately hit a. This is just raw footage. I immediately hit a fucking leaf right after it.
A leaf?
I went way too fast down the trail. The thing through the car is fucking ugly as shit. But then I was going around the corner here, a leaf pops up. So this is my whole cool. Planned shot thing, and I just thought, okay, I'm not here to hang out, not to worry
that's
about
so
like,
aggravating.
Shot somewhere. So that fucking didn't work out.
All right,
one
so
bit like I wanted
this
to, but then,
is
I got it and
just
I started cruising around. Is really fun.
Long enough.
I'll show you what that looks like. Henceforth,
not
yeah,
really.
Yeah, I was just fucking like cruising around. Having
God
a good time.
Damn it!
I was thoroughly enjoying myself at this fucking campsite. Yeah, that leaf just popped up out of nowhere, too. And the funny thing is, I couldn't see it in my FPV cam. It was just covering the GoPro. And on this run, actually,
right,
a little fucking sticky leaf covered up my FPV cam. But
I haven't really talked about it much.
Whatever, but
drop bot down a little bit. I have not talked about it much, but Cinewhooping is weird, man. They fly like a bag of fucking assholes. And I have like the best flying. What?
It's like Inception streaming. It's like you're streaming.
We had a third one on there too, and Bot and I were managing to talk at each other.
Oh.
Through this, we're gonna do it again. It worked shockingly well. Yeah, and I have like apparently the best flying Cinewhoop ever, according to anybody that has ever flown it or built a Cinesplore. But yeah, my God, they fly fucking horrible. Like. I was, yeah, I got to put some time in on the Cinewhoops to figure out the fucking weirdness, man, because they're just like, yeah, I mean, not good. Just having the ducts are just such an unbelievable imposition. It's not the right word. The ducts are not good. They just, they catch every, they do all bad things. And, yeah, they just, they're just bad. Ducks are bad. You heard it here first. Ducks, bad.
I might make an edit out of a bunch of this footage. I don't fucking know. I might make a little, like, mini background edit and put it out tomorrow.
All right, I'm just doing these last couple motor wires. There's really nothing for you guys to see right now. I'm just soldering motor wires. All right, two more of these to do, and I'm going to wrap this shit up. Weirdo the Skateboard says, why don't you do a bacon build stream if you're down with barking on the stream? I like that idea a lot, actually. Do like a double bacon build stream. Double bacon, B-A-C-O-N, build. Oh my god, yes. Double bacon build stream. Bacon build stream. That's it. Double bacon build stream. That way I'm not overtly saying, hey, come watch me smoke weed. Let me type it into, let's do a double bacon. There we go. We'll both build and curse and scream. There we go. There we go. We'll both build and curse and scream. There we go. Yeah, y'all, man, right? Ultra ADHD. It's about to come to an end, though. Don't you worry. Okay. Here we go. Second to last wire being soldered down. I hope you guys are excited.
It took me a second. I was like, hang on. To make sure I'm reading this correctly. Thank you so much for the donation, Maniac. Of course, it's 421 just to be a dick, I'm assuming.
All right. And come on, you jerk. Get in there.
Yo, I'm going to have to go. I
think I just
grabbed it and left it there. Your super chat did pop up.
Come on. There it goes. There we go.
OC Maryland camp on the beach. I think I can replay it, actually.
All right, last one. Last one, and then I get to go watch Bot on the TV on the couch and relax a little bit. What you guys know about that? You need to get some food? I'm fucking starving. Kristen has a food dream that she would like to tell me. I'm concerned. She wants Taco Bell. You want to go out and get it while I finish this?
Oh, yeah. What do you want to get? To surprise you?
Well, we get the same shit every time.
Yeah, but do you want anything specific?
God damn it. No, I'm good. I was god damn it-ing the soldering iron, not you. Why what, so is this fucking solder gonna melt or
very come on, man. At the vampire spot, we really should call it something going to the vampire smith.
There we go.
Going to rip this fucking shit up.
Hey, soldering iron, thank you for that.
Do it one more time. Yeah, I knew it. Do it one more time, grilled cheese. I knew it. We're in for a treat tonight, y'all. I think I jammed them.
You want me to come with you?
Do it
okay, good. Because I didn't want to. I was just saying it to be nice. Yep.
Oh, bonus one. Grilled cheese, look at that. Look what you get for $5. 37 pop-ups.
Ugh, man, I do not like how tight these are.
Nuclear.
That's...
Okay. Legit, how many more times this is
wait, no, this will be fine. Yeah, I'll do that. That's fine.
I think I jammed it a bunch, and when I should have been patient,
No, it's not. It's not fine. This is too short. Fucking fucker! I have to do it the right way. Don't!
Oh my god.
Don't!
There you go, girl. That is a huge silo. Those little exit holes are pretty fucking...
Send me some pizza, Yaw Man Flight says. Yaw Man!
Did we already see a dive?
I want pizza.
We had saw a dive and I was worried about things.
Apparently there's a new website or application for the phone or something or other where streamers can streamers can put like their favorite foods on there and then you guys can go Marley Leppo with a WhatsApp and 50 Norwegian kroners. Thank you, Marley Leppo.
I'm up pressing
much appreciated.
Like,
yeah, and then people can order you food from that thing. So I don't know. Should I do that? Do you guys want to?
I would never.
Do you guys want to do that?
Our guest is coming on in 10 minutes because I wasted 15 minutes of the fucking stream talking about my stupid camping trip. That's fucking incredible. If you want to see the rest of that.
Okay. Why so short?
Full smashing shit.
Why so short?
That was a sick inverted, y'all.
Alright, this needs to be a little bit longer here.
That was a fucking a great sense of intro.
And we're gonna choppy choppy that long.
The guest is a surprise. That's the whole thing. Is the guest tonight is a surprise.
Oh shit!
I didn't pick anybody on the community corner last week. I wanted to have a surprise guest.
Who's it gonna be?
Wait, does my mic bend?
Place your bets. Yeah, it's like we're having a conversation, right, y'all, man?
Oh, it's all good, bro.
In my mind, that's what it is.
I leave too when my stuff breaks.
I doubt that's actually not what it is. I doubt it's actually like that.
Hey, Marley Leppo with that
donate. Oh, shit. Marley Leppo doubling up. That was cool. That's awesome. Good on you, Marley Leppo.
Did anybody else go camping this fucking weekend? Billy Hackett having a good memory.
Come on, get in there, Salder.
Hey,
there
we go. TFU is becoming the newest patron to the Bach Grinder Patreon. Thank you so much.
Man, I need to get Streamlabs going. He's got that cool shit that makes noises when people sub. That's so cool.
I'm actually trying to buy
fancy
like
ass Bach Grinder. God damn it.
For everybody. And if my Patreon somehow magically, if it gets up to 3,000 a month, then I'm putting away $1,000 a month out of that land, so in 20 months at least we can pay off FPV land.
Oh my god.
Idea, right? So
if you guys aren't subbed,
let that dream become a reality,
get your ass over there. That's a great fucking idea. Fuck yeah.
Pretty luck, super chatting.
One of the many reasons Bot Grinder is so fucking great. Okay, so this is now.
Check that rank out.
Now the other one is too short.
Is in Warzone, you better fucking check out what the carrot cake is, because you can get squad fights all day, motherfucker. Oh my god, it's Bong Slide! Bong Slide, welcome to the thing. Oh, I get been in here. Yes, Bong Slide. I have this ultimate plan. I need to raise $25,000, and then I can buy 10 acres of land, raw undeveloped land, and we can turn it into a 10 acre fucking FPV park. Isn't that a great idea? And check this part out.
Best goddamn idea I've ever heard.
For $5,000 to companies or individuals with $5,000. So when I have giant events, you have your own acre to do whatever the fuck you want to do on. For your company, set up a big booth and a little track or something. If you're a person, set up an acre worth of a fucking campground on your acre that you bought for $5,000 on the world's first FPV park.
Yeah, I'm down.
Right. And 25 grand is a lot, but crowdsource, that ain't fucking shit. I got spots picked out. I have found 10 acres of land for $25,000.
Motherfuckers, we're going to have Ciotti land for sure.
So I can take care of the land and shit like
it'll
that.
It'll be micros only, except for when I get there. And then it'll be 5-inch only.
From a lot of fucking places. I'm like 20 minutes away from 3 different states. You know what I'm saying? Like, the land would be very accessible to everybody. So That is my whole fucking goal for the fucking thing.
For a Nas?
So if you have, you know.
What's a Nas, Tiago? Teach. Marley Lebo with 50 more Norwegian kroner saying, teach Botgrinder how to say waza.
Whatever you can afford, some redneck shit, fly drones in Ocala. That sounds fucking fantastic, Mr. BB Junkie. I would love to do that. And thank you so much for the donate. Looks like I'm going to be playing me some Super Mario 3D motherfucking all.
God damn it. Tip of the soldering iron is disgustingly dirty. Now it's better. There we go.
Patreon. Here we got motherfucking Huggin' about to kill it. Huggin' about to kill it right now.
Come on, get in there. Oh my god, Kristen's bringing fucking Taco Bell back, guys. Are you kidding me? Get you one that buys you Taco Bell. Get you one that buys you Taco Bell, people.
And then I'm going to hit that shit fucking hard for like 2 to 3 months or until I make the fucking money.
Oh, okay. There's just some beeping.
Start a massive fundraising event and fail at like $6,000 or something. That would be embarrassing for everybody around. So I've been talking about it for a couple of years now. I'm not going to start it until I'm like fucking ready and shit. You know what I mean? Also, anybody that obviously pitched in for it, even a low amount, could just go to the land and rip whenever they want or whatever until it's like a whole fucking thingy, you know what? But if it's close enough to me, then we can just go out there and fucking rip whatever we want.
Oh, come on. Why does soldering sometimes just...
Okay, we got some questions in there.
Never mind. Sometimes soldering is just, like, impossible for no reason.
Except I don't have any extra quad stuff. I guess I could buy some and then auction them and make some money on them. That's not a bad idea.
Come on. Clean it off, bro.
Julian Vincent, that's actually a song about Mario by,
Come on. Clean.
Is it Ugly Frank? I think, yeah, it's Ugly Frank. Ugly Frank does a song.
There we go. Jesus, that's all I wanted to do? Was that so difficult?
Skidoosh in the chat. What's up, Skidoosh? Welcome to the thing.
Welcome to the thing.
That's so fog, saying Sputnik. Well, that's fucking terrifying. Long slide. Yes, I am on Twitch. I've only been playing the FPV Sims, but I used to do gaming with the celebrities. It was a summer series I did. Every week it was a different celebrity playing a different video game.
Happening?
Those videos should still be up on the Twitch. You should go check it out. It's fun. I play games with Barwell, UAV Futures, Cricket, Gravy
Lake. Oh, I remember that. That was fun.
Matt played Call of Duty Mobile, but on our PCs and just fucking wrecked people. It was fucking awesome. Shotgun FPV. What's up, Shotgun? How are you doing, buddy? And Reedy's in the house too. Hello.
I feel like I never have time for video games. Like, any time I'm like, oh, I would like to play a video game right now, I'm just like, no, I have 18 edits to do, though. Like,
but I did the thing.
I haven't played video games in forever.
How are we doing?
Like, multiple years. It's been.
Oh, bro, FBV. What we got, oh, bro? Fucking get ready for some shit.
Alright. I think I'm good now. Yay, it's not bridged. Right, thank you, world, for not making me... Never mind. Okay, checking my work, and then we can probably wrap this thing up so I can eat some Taco Bell.
Not lies, I get... Right? You said, what's up? My bad. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I said it all stupid. It's not like you said it. Maniac.
Network attached storage. You have storage to retire... That the storage is not the issue. It's just time. It's not even. It is time. The issue is I don't feel like doing it. But I will say this: I am doing all of T-Pain's edits on the laptop to force myself, and I'm gonna try to even do the full edit from that event on the laptop. So that'll help a lot.
I think we could raise as a community $25,000.
Rito with the skateboard says, is it bad if it's taken nine months to build one quad? Blown up 3 ESCs, 1 flight controller, 1 motor, 1 receiver, 1 VTX, and a camera, and it hasn't flown once. Weirdo, no, that's not weird at all. That's pretty much this whole fucking hobby in a nutshell. It ain't just you, man. There's that, you're in the majority there. Okay, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of my video as I piece this thing back together. And then I'm going to shut this fucker down. And I'll see you guys either tomorrow or Sunday. Maybe tomorrow, though. Maybe. So this guy's good. I just need to stick these... I just want to stick these... the race wires and the arm LEDs down.
Oh shit, we're gonna be bringing our guest on in
and we'll
one
be good.
Hey guest, after this video,
who the hell
you on? JT Wild moving. Oh,
is Bot Grinder's guest? What if it was me, guys? What if this was all one big,
I appreciate that.
One big fucking
saying,
donkey.
Figure out how to,
I mean, it would make sense, right?
Stream my Switch.
It would make sense for it to be me, wouldn't it? You know what I mean?
I do have a capture card that Fish sent me. If I can figure out how to work that, then I'll totally plug my Switch in, and I'll play Mario 64 on Twitch, if anybody's interested in that. You want to watch
this nice, Marley. Marley Lepo with 50 more kroners. Letting us know that he schooled Botsy.
Pretty much every Tuesday I do a
good on you, Marley.
Off, I've been wanting to play different video games.
All right. Number two.
The Cold War Alpha's out. Yeah, I've seen that. I don't think I'm going to get Cold War, though. I don't even really play fucking...
In the toilet?
Like Warzone all fucking day. But there might be some cool-ass, like, gun or something in Cold War that make you buy it for Warzone. Oh, shit. Jack Johnson becoming a fucking big ol' $50 patron. That means, Jack Johnson, you
damn
get the Patreon exclusive Bot Grinder shirt.
Bot's got those famous fucking subscribers. Jack Johnson, man.
Thank you so much, first of all.
I don't like that guy's music,
but also second of all, hey guest, you're coming on in a minute. Second of all, I got a shirt. It's just for patrons. There's no other way to get it.
Alright, sticking that down.
So keep holding on to that and hope. I will fucking, as soon as that...
Oh, hey, yeah, I forgot to pimp my own shit out, guys. CiottiFPV.com, you go there. And you can see all the shit that I got going. I got stickers. I got fucking... I'll work for you on Fiverr. I got t-shirts from Teespring.
It's time for our guest. I hope our guest is ready.
Get on over there. Oh, Bot's guest is ready. It's me. I was just kidding. It's me. No, it's not.
Who do we have here?
It's Zoro. It's that Zoro guy. Zorogan.
There, Zoro. Good, man.
Like Zoro. A.
It's good to see you.
I think it's pronounced.
Two. Why is there a check mark?
Zara E.
Gentleman PewDiePie of a check mark.
I think Zara E.
Check mark.
You've played us from Sims.
You fucking do that shit. Did you get PewDiePie on your shit, dude? No, just somebody with that name and an emoji check mark.
Oh, weirdo. Nice. I will be in touch for sure. Pesky says, "What's up?" Had some bad times, so it's good to catch up with you. I feel you on that, Pesky. That's been a rough...
I forgot what it was. I forgot what it was.
Month.
I had this whole thing lined up. So
it's not just you, man. Glad to have you back. If you're not over on... if you're not over on our Facebook group called FPV Space Therapy, get on over.
I know, I heard.
Or just reach out. You guys can always reach out. Danny Bauer says, that sentence is wild. I'm doing all of T-Pain's edits on the laptop. Yeah, it's... it's crazy. It's a weird world that I've been thrust into. Still talking to him every day. Trying to just not be a fucking idiot and ruin it. Which is hard, because it's like, ooh, I got 8,000 things I want to tell T-Pain about myself. You got to just, be like, nope, shut up, idiot, shut up. Only tell him about the edit. Shut up, idiot. Don't tell him you used to be a drummer, he doesn't give a fuck. Shut up, you idiot. That's kind of just my advice for life. Shut up, you idiot. That's,
I know everything about Fermion.
That'll take you far in life. Shut up, you idiot.
No, panspermia. Yeah, it's not transfermia. I was because it's transferring, but... Yeah, I think that's, like, legit. Like,
all right, look at that.
So, along the asteroids and they hit our Earth without burning out.
We got some shit down there. Now to see if this all fits under the top plate.
I know, dude.
It should. It fucking better.
More stuff about the whole UFO thing. They're gonna like, they're gonna talk about shit.
Come on, get in there. Oh yeah, it's gonna fit. Oh, it's gonna fit. Look at this fat little fucker. Ooh!
He's always wearing different brands of hats, like Ford and UPS.
Okay. Let's get this fucker screwed down to see what's going on. Just duct tape it. There it is. Thanks for dropping that link, Remy Tim.
Oh, it's been great. I just Buddha was talking about the Stone Ape Theory. I guess I have heard of it.
Go.
Yes, I have.
That's where they got a lot of like oxygen in their brains, right? And then they is that it?
No, the Stone Ape Theory, as far as I understand it, is that we were all
ape
like
walking
around.
Here we go. It's happening. Guys, it's happening.
Magic mushrooms or something like that.
Oh, God.
And then we were inspired.
Oh shit, this went in all fucking sideways. Why is it going in all crooked? What the fuck is going on here? Get your little ass straight down on there. Oh, I think it just looks like it's threading crooked. Look at this, man, you guys are just looking at some real good quality fucking video right now.
From ape mode to human mode as a, like,
oh my god. All right, there you go.
And then that's where we're at right
so
now.
So there's that, and yeah, that's what this build looks like. Well, shit, there's even room for... Wow, there's actually a half-decent amount of room in there. Wait, no, you can't see it from that side. There's a little bit of room in there. Look at that. So there you go. There's this is going to get sent to Brad. I might send it without... setting it up. Nah, I guess I'll do a setup on it and then send it.
I don't know. I guess they like their
I really don't need to, but like, and I do have a box that's going out like to them.
Just
grab a couple.
Matty Blunt says Stone Zoro theory. So
grab a couple M3x6s here.
How many have you done DMT, bro? We tried DMT. How many times have you tried DMT? Because let me tell you, I've tried DMT.
They're talking about drugs.
All right, I'm telling you.
They're talking about drugs, guys.
DMT. I got
they're talking about
chamber under DMT.
Drugs.
That's a fucking, literally a spaceship.
Oh my god, a spaceship.
Did you really do it, or are you being Joe Rogan?
I was being Joe Rogan.
He was being Joe Rogan.
Give it to me. I have money and everything. If you have money, and if you have DMT and need some money.
I don't know if you guys just heard that, but Bacha said, if you have DMT and need money. That's the dream right there.
And they have like DMT cards. You can buy them legally. But they're like $200.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, $200.
A couple hundred bucks. That's not bad.
Oh, wow.
I like that, man.
I mean, I was already out, but now I'm definitely out.
Well, I got myself relaxed. And this, and I've been meditating ever since, even after the. Like, you got me meditating, like, daily, right? And I did it.
Yeah, this is fine.
Hell of time, dude. I almost finished a whole cartridge.
Oh, my God!
With the pipe. I didn't say that. But I was on...
Oh, jeez!
I was on the FDMA, so, like...
Zorro! That sounds,
the boy.
That's fine.
But I'm not gonna put it out.
Sure, it's fine. Battery straps. Let me throw some battery straps in here right fucking now because this is a real bastard to get them in after the fact. Where are the battery straps over here? I put them in a bag and now the bag is gone. That's not gone well.
Because of the MDMA, like, nothing can really go wrong.
Where the hell?
It was such a fucking amazing trip. It was like, I did it with my eyes open. To see, like, what happened, bro.
Fuck! So where
crazy.
Is it?
It's so crazy.
Kitten!
Anyway.
Where'd it go? Where is it? Hey, here we go.
I'm gonna do the... You're right. Uh-oh.
So my lizards... My lizards... Oh! Timer. And my, My webcam.
Do you have your webcam thing?
There we go. Okay.
It's on. It's on. So my laser
it's time.
A timer and I plug my webcam.
It's time. Oh, these are going to be too fucking long, aren't they? I need little short ones for the. I need little short ones for the. God damn it. Yeah, I need short ones. I need short ones.
Everybody's over 18 here, right? Webcam timer now.
You where are the short ones at?
So that was 10 minutes. That was a really fun interview. I literally had a reason to bring you on. I forgot.
Where are the short ones at?
I can't remember what it was when I don't fucking care anymore. This was fantastic. Now I just everything to be some fucking D&D.
Yeah.
Oh, I figured it out, by the way.
God
so
damn it.
I got a 09K, although I didn't want to. I'm doing a video because I... Because all my mounts and all my
batteries... Yawman Flights, Race Day Quads, but they don't make a Dr. Pepper one.
Thing in the front, so, but whatever, right?
But Race Day Quads has them. They're called, like, vanity labels. They have some weird fucking name.
Zoom and some other shit. So that's why
I need short and thin battery straps. Short and skinny.
Nice.
That doesn't exist. I'm just gonna use these.
You know,
then.
Like, when you're at a concert and you run on stage and take a picture
with the crowd. I've always wanted to do that because you know I have been on stages, but the crowd is always like 12 people way in the back, so it would. I always do the front man thing too. I'd be like, come on, just come on front. You know what I mean? Get closer. Let's go. And when people don't listen to you, it's the worst fucking feeling ever. So I didn't do it a whole lot. And like, if I didn't think the crowd was respond. You're like, come on, everybody, move on up. They don't move.
Yeah.
Fuck. You look like an idiot. But when they do move up, you're like, yeah, and you rock out.
Yeah.
I mean, the point of that is because you play a fast song and you push somebody and they knock into somebody and you get a mosh pit going. And then when there's photos of your band being taken, it looks sick when people are moshing and like playing. That was all.
Okay, so if I run this battery strap under, I kind of like the way it works. When it's under here.
That has been your 10 minutes. I appreciate you coming on. You can hang out and watch some of these Patreon videos if you want. I could like pop your screen up. You see a little lag on the thing.
Get in there. There it is. Okay, yeah, so I'm going to use that to hold the battery lead down too, which is probably a stupid idea, but I'm all about those stupid ideas. What? I wonder what Taco Bell Kristen went to. I feel like she's been gone a while. I hope she's okay. Sure, she's okay. How the fuck am I going
to
get this one under?
But we're going to watch these videos. Let's see, baby.
No, dude, I don't care. I just want to say hi.
It's been so fun.
Wait a second. How am I going to get this shit under here? Oh, this is
appreciate you as always.
Fucking
nightmare. Yes, air hug. Air internet hug.
Later, dude. Thank you, Zoro. I appreciate it, buddy. Bye. There, go watch Zoro's channel.
Oh, my God. Why is this?
I don't know why you want it.
Okay. If I pull this way. Oh, come on. Get out of here. You get out of here, too. God damn
it. Thank you so much for going on. Oh, Gravy
Legs! Oh, you god damn it.
Oh, Gravy Legs, welcome.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. There it is. Okay. Now I just have to go up through here. And...
Flying better than some of you.
Get up in there. Get up in there.
Look at this. Tiny train. Shut the fuck up. Is it okay? Is there a big train? That's a pearl train. It's a fucking huge train.
All right. I got them battery straps in there. Or not. There it is. Wow, I gotta do something about this. All right, hold on.
This fool is so fucking good. Oh, look at the birds. And crazy train on piano. Oh, an ad board, a Mr. Donation ad board, thank you so much. Saying,
oh, there we go.
Saying grilled cheese donated $5. Have one. Hey. Hey. Good, all right? What do you have for? Hey. Chuck Toast saying,
there we go.
Goggles calls are
that's pretty good.
Cousin in the park, that is very true.
Okay. We got some battery strapes. We got some... I think this is almost long enough.
Jackson, thank you so much for becoming my newest Patreon patron. I appreciate that so much.
This
Chuck Waters for you, bro.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if I love the way this is, I do have an idea, though. Look what I can do. Because I'm trying to keep... I'm trying to keep these separated a little bit.
And only for a little bit. I will chase a bird now and then.
So I can do that, like this.
Don't get too close. And don't freak out too fucking much.
Yeah, I guess you're already freaking out. Oh, yeah! There we go. So that'll hold that red bastard. And then... Yeah, that's good. That's good.
Super Deluxe, you want Chuck Hot Sauce again? Bro, I've been eating fucking undercooked campfire burgers. My guts are already a little bit wrecked today.
Okay, cool. That's pretty good. It's not perfect, but again, back up to a backup to the backup rig.
A lot more. Go check out Carbon Cage, the youngest river in the world.
Here we go.
But probably through the super young, and he's fucking awesome. Our motherfucking Scopes saying it's dad time. Holy shit, it is dab time. I didn't have the proper graphic on the thing last time I did it. But that makes us hit the goal of $59 for Super Mario. Holy fuck, I should go grab my motherfucking Switch.
Look at this coming together.
Shit right now.
Hope you guys are ready.
Mario before you take a hey, absolute zero. Welcome to the motherfucker.
Yo man gets Bot Grinder through my stream quicker than it comes through his phone. I think that's because I have myself set on ultra low latency, which would also explain why him and I were able to talk to each other when we were doing Streamception. That's funny. That's actually like really funny.
All right, go.
I want to show it to you guys with the motor bells on it.
Struggling out there. I did that earlier. Shall we do it again?
Who? No.
Please stop fucking with the wild.
I'm not struggling. I'm okay. I mean, I'm always struggling, but, you know.
I only do it for a little bit. I don't get too close, but do not fuck with wildlife.
Okay. I have tested these bells, and these are the four that...
Marley, that were playing Ciotti's video.
I think...
In this live stream.
Are the best balanced.
He could play his...
Oh, look at that!
From my stream.
It's us!
And super incept the stream. Is it? Oh, don't hit that guy. That guy got scared as fuck. Oh, he's trying to go through the window.
Oh, this needs...
We get absolute zero?
This needs audio, though.
Ooh, super deluxe. We
That's
got
okay.
Right there, bro. I'm not going anywhere tomorrow.
I'm
going
to put one of these...
Philadelphia, so that will be good for me.
I'm going to put this guy on the... back, I think, here. Hi, kitten! You're rubbing up on me.
Oh my god, we have the Invent a Trick contest coming up tonight. If you don't know,
never
last week,
give up, guys. Never, ever, ever, ever give up.
Selects your bid as the number one bid, and we're going to be doing that after a few more Patreon edits. I'm very...
They are full drib motors. Yeah, Bell and Stator.
If you want to see the rest of that bid, head on, or if you want to see bids like that, head on over to Ciotti. He's stealing the car via Cineloop, so Super Deluxe. Yes, it does appear to be so. Here we got Cat's World, ripping it.
Okay, why are you not Cat's fucking World. Spinning?
Week 7, back-to-back Maddie's.
Okay. That's annoying. Kitty,
oh,
no!
Get over here with those fucking double waters.
Bad.
Back up.
Bad kitten. Oh. It's nowhere near your feeding time, buddy. Weirdo, you can. They just have to be the same manufacturer.
There is one thing I'm doing different tonight on tonight's stream that I've never done. I usually have my studio lights. I have two big fucking studio lights, thanks to the homie. And I usually have those, you know, to do the green screen and everything. But for some reason... Well, I mean, I forgot to turn them on. For some reason, it works. Like, there's no shitty green screen fucking fluff or nothing. Like, look at the edges.
Yeah, they have to match, though. Like you. I mean, obviously, you can't go, like, 2306 to 2207. But you also can't, yeah, it has to be the same motor. I'm sure I don't have to explain this. It's got to be the same motor, but just a different KV variant. There we go. There are some words that... makes sense when said together in a long string. Come on, shipbird, get in there. Hold on, let me check my phone to make sure, like, Kristen's not upside down on fire.
Flying fucking roofs outside during the nighttime is so fucking fun, man. Y'all ever do that? Y'all ever just go out to, like, a parking lot at night? It's really fucking fun. Or even a micro. Like, you ain't even gotta bring a 5-inch and go hard. Just bring a micro or a little woof and go cruise around. It's fucking great. Get it, bro. May I? Hang on. I would like to see... Look at this. I would like to see your radio stance, though. I don't know if I've seen such a... It's low. You hold it down. I'm not talking shit at all, so nobody think that. I've just never seen anybody with the stance of it so low. I like that. I dig that, bro. A very, very unique radio hold there. Dragon Ears rips his 5-inch at night. That is extra fun. I've seen a whoop is just like, cruise around, you know, do some fucking cool whoop shit. 5-inch sometimes is a little heavy for me at night, especially in a small spot. I don't want to, like, be sketched out, but little micros are just fucking perfect. Super Deluxe got Cobb Skills audition with me and Bot for a third all weekend. Super Deluxe, 766-5549. Hit up Super Deluxe if you're fucking sick with it at Call of Duty. And maybe you could join me, Super Deluxe, and Absolute Zero in playing some Warzone. You get first place, like all.
Oh, Trump people. I can't. I fucking can't. Kitten, what are you doing under here? Why do you keep brushing up against me? I got you. I just fucking grabbed his belly and just shook the shit out of it. Alright. Next.
Eugene Mads, I play on PC as the Super Deluxe.
Yeah, man, these motors are dirty. Brad, what did you do to these? You crash these motors into the fucking Sahara Desert? They're so dirty! And I think the bearings are pretty fucked up too, but I'm just gonna wait. I'm gonna fly it a little bit and see if the bearings loosen up. And then I have a feeling I'm gonna end up swapping them out. Yeah, you know what? I'm not just gonna throw it in a box. I am gonna fly it. No. No, Daniel, it's something else. Schizo.
I feel like it makes
long story.
Having the pressure on the strap like that, you know what I mean? Because I have thumb. So I need every little advantage I can fucking get.
Yeah, I know, right?
I had a really interesting here.
What Taco Bell did you go to?
Everyone wanted Taco Bell tonight, I think.
There was a big line at Taco Bell.
I was like the sixth person in line when I got there, like, screw it.
Alright guys, here you go. Here's what it looks like with the bells on it. Just back this off a little bit. There we go. That's what a flow ride looks like. It's got no ass. Look at that. It's got no ass at all. No butt. It's a buttless quad. But it's a good one. There it is, fellas. All right, that's it for me. Go watch Bot without me in the background screaming. And I'll catch you guys either tomorrow or Sunday. I mean, Sunday for sure, as Kristen rightly points out. Oh, hey, I've got a replacement board for the Hummingbird from Newbie Drone, so that'll be cool. And... I got all kinds of fun stuff coming up. I'll talk to you guys either tomorrow or Sunday. Good boy. Ooh, good boy.